Okay, so the BJP General Secretary Vinod Tawde, the man in the eye of the storm, his briefing has been cancelled as the Maharashtra police refused to allow him to go ahead with the press conference. Now, Tawde has been booked for campaigning before polls. It was illegal for him to be at that hotel, which is hours to go for polling. He's been booked for that. He's also been booked for cash seizure. But at this point, when he tried to hold a press conference to go ahead and put out his point of view of what happened, that was called off. The cops didn't allow him to hold a press conference. I want to bring in Saurabh Vakhtania on this broadcast. Saurabh, take us through exactly what happened. Why was the BJP General Secretary not allowed to hold a press conference?
Well, actually, let me tell you, these are the guidelines which have been made by the Election Commission. Remember, once the campaigning is over, and yesterday the campaigning actually got over, till the 48 hours, till the voting does not start, you cannot take any press conference. And this is what the police, Mumbai police DCP Munde has reached at this particular media center of the BJP in South Mumbai. They are clearly telling that you cannot take a press conference. So what we are learning from our sources, that very likely Vinod Tawde might give a media bite. Like, there will be mics of the media people over there, and while going through this particular media center, it's very likely that Vinod Tawde may give a bite. But taking a press conference according to the rule, because this is a silent period, and at this particular time you cannot take a press conference. Remember, a very serious allegations against Vinod Tawde. There are total 3 FIRs which have been filed in this entire case. In one of the FIR, Vinod Tawde is also mentioned. In one of the, in two FIR, let me tell you, BJP candidate of local BJP candidate from this particular place is mentioned. And in one FIR, both the parties, BJP and the BVA, are named in the FIR. So total 3 FIRs have been filed in this entire case. At 6 p.m., Vinod Tawde was supposed to take a press conference, but clearly Mumbai police has intervened, saying that right now you cannot take a press conference.
It's a violation of norms that 12 hours before polling, there's a press conference. So he's not going to be allowed to do that. Saurabh telling us there's a possibility that he will, however, issue a quick statement to the media as well. I want to bring in Ritwik Balika. There's a lot of confusion, Ritwik, over whether Vinod Tawde has been booked by the EC over this cash for votes allegation, or whether he's been booked over the fact that he was at this hotel, which by itself is a violation.
See, after a UN cry over these videos which were surfacing almost on the mobile phones of everyone, the WhatsApp was flooded with videos from Virar, where the incident has happened. So even Mahavikas Aghadi leaders, opposition leaders also demanded that the Election Commission should take action immediately, and also local police should swing into action. Election Commission of Maharashtra has taken a suo moto action, registering an FIR where Vinod Tawde is booked for flouting and violation of People's Representation Act. Like Saurabh said and rightly pointed out, that within 48 hours of the voting, one cannot held meetings, or one cannot campaign. So Vinod Tawde was holding a meeting of BJP Karyakartas, as he was himself clarifying in his press conference, saying that he was trying to he was trying to explain them what are the guidelines.
I'm just going to come back to you. I want to take this across quickly to Saurabh Vakhtania. Saurabh, take it away. I see a lot of activity where you are. I see police officials have arrived there.
Well, let me do the collector of Palghar district is over here right now. You can see this is the lobby area of the Vivanta Hotel, and the senior cops along with all the officials are present over here. They are right now going to the fourth floor. There are the very senior officials present over here. This is the exclusive visuals on India Today. We are breaking that how the senior officials are now going to the fourth floor, and they will be checking the rooms from where this particular cache was found. This is the exclusive breaking visuals right now on India Today. This is the inside visuals, and we are the senior cops and the officials administration from the Palghar district. And let me tell you, on the fourth floor, it was been said that Vinod Tawde's room was booked. There were other rooms which are booked on the second floor, and from where this particular cache was found. Three FIs have been filed, Akshita. First is that in the 48 hours, you cannot leave your constituency. You cannot campaign. There were BJP banners, flags and symbols which were recovered by the police officials. Second is the most important part is total 9,53,900 rupees. That is the amount of cash which has been seized by the election officials from this particular hotel. So let me tell you, 9,53,900 rupees. This is the amount of cash which has been filed. So police have filed the second FIR. The third FIR is about the illegal press conference with both the parties from the BJP and BVA represent over here. Vinod Tavade reached this particular hotel at 11:30, and let me tell you, the BVA got a tip-off, and clearly now it's been tell by Hitendra Thakur that it was actually
that tip-off the BVA from the BJP, says or whether this is the Bahujan Vikas Aghadi. The BVA says that this tip-off actually came from the BJP. So that's added a whole new layer to this entire political saga. I want to bring in Mustafa Sheikh, who's at the venue where the press conference by Vinod Tavade was to be held. As we've broken and told you here on India Today, that press conference stands cancelled. We're expecting, Mustafa, that there will be some interaction where Vinod Tavade will put forth his version, because the biggest question that's being asked right now is about who actually tipped off the BVA. Because you've got this allegation doing the rounds right now, which the BVA themselves have put forth, that it was the BJP that actually targeted Vinod Tavade. Mustafa, any clarity that's come on that front? There are a lot of questions being put forth to Tavade on whether this is a result of some sort of rebellion within the BJP.
Well, of course, and these questions are being raised not just by Sanjay Raut, who's a political opponent, but also Hitendra Thakur, who had made this entire allegation and brought this entire thing public light. He is saying that he got a tip-off from a senior leader of the BJP. Sanjay Raut had went on to point fingers at Devendra Fadnavis, saying that Devendra Fadnavis had tipped off Hitendra Thakur. So clearly, it is more so that it is not only the allegation of cash for votes, the internal rivalry allegedly of the BJP is also coming to fore just before elections. Vinod Tavade was, you know, he was there, but who knew that he was there specifically at which hotel? How did the BVA workers got to know? How were they so confident that he was distributing cash that they directly went and confronted him without asking him anything, and then they were able to find cash in a bag, they were able to find a diary? So these are things which are important in terms of, if you look at the political optics of it, of the allegations, and also of the opposition not only pointing fingers at the cash for vote scam of the BJP, but they're also saying that it's also the internal rivalry of the BJP which is coming to fore, and Vinod Tavade is being targeted. That's the second important thing which has come out of today's highlight. Vinod Tavade was going to address a press conference, but the police has denied him permission, hence the press conference is cancelled. Pooja, back to you.
All right, Mustafa, this is Akshita here, but Mustafa, Saurabh and Ritwik getting us all of those updates from Ground Zero. They are going to remain with us and get us every single political twist that's emerging in this story.